Thank you all for coming. We're here to announce an update in the case with Nita Mohammed Niazi, joined here by Sheriff Jim Cooper, Under Sheriff Mike Ziegler, Chief of Sac State Police Chet Madison, and FBI Special Agent in Charge Sean Reagan. We'll turn it over to Sheriff Cooper.
Good afternoon. Thank you all for being here. As Mr. Ghani said, we announced the arrest of Mr. Niazi on two cases of sexual assault with two separate victims. The cases occurred last fall. Both victims were students at Sacramento State University, and both cases were investigated by Sacramento State Police Department. Detective from the Sacramento State Police identified the suspect as Mr. Niazi. Our Major Crimes Bureau and FBI Sacramento Violent Crimes Task Force assigned to assist with the investigation. The Sheriff's Major Crimes Bureau detectives were able to locate Mr. Niazi in Germany. The FBI and Interpol helped facilitate the arrest, and Mr. Niazi is in Germany right now awaiting extradition. So I'll turn it over to Chief Madison.
Thank you, Sheriff. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm just going to provide some brief context of the case that occurred this past fall. On September 20th, 2022, our first survivor reported that the assault occurred on August 21st, 2022, in the Sacramento County jurisdiction. On October 21st, our second survivor reported that the assault occurred on September 18th, 2022, on campus. And then on November 9th, 2022, an arrest warrant was issued by a judge here in Sacramento County for Mr. Niazi, who's 31 years old, on multiple felony counts. I want to note that this is an active and ongoing investigation. Any community members on campus or outside of campus, we strongly urge you, if you have any information regarding this investigation or any other investigation potentially associated to Mr. Niazi, to contact the Sacramento State Police Department. And before I turn it over to Special Agent Charge Reagan, I do want to note that the importance of the collaboration and partnerships that we have in this case with our local partners, the Sheriff's Office, and our federal partners. This could not have been accomplished without their help. So I'll turn it over to Special Agent Sean Reagan.
Thanks, Chief. Thanks, Sheriff. Good afternoon, everybody. So based, as was said, on the strong partnerships that we have, a request was made for the FBI to become involved in looking for the fugitive and suspect in this particular set of crimes. We got our international office involved. We have agents and personnel assigned in over 60 different locations around the world, one of them being in Germany. And so getting Interpol and our agents over in Germany involved to help locate the suspect. They did so, and he was apprehended by the German authorities. And that was based on the local warrant and also a federal warrant that we obtained for unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. And that's when someone flees the state or the country to avoid being captured or prosecuted. And based on that, the German police were our international partners, and they arrested the subject based on our request. And they currently have him in custody, and he will be awaiting extradition back to the United States.